Hello everyone, today we are here at WaterSedge for the official launch of SlimDigi's 2.0. The speciality is they're holding the first ever online press conference in Sri Lanka today to redefine the digital marketing aspect of Sri Lanka and to initiate SlimDigi's Awards 2.0. Stay tuned with me as I unfold this conference to you. I'm Ashingsani Veerasinghe and you are with Pulse.
One fundamental change in terms of the judging process this year is the complete elimination of the presentation in round two. This was actually part of our roadmap which we designed at the inception and at the time we conceptualized the program last year. So we have now, with our learnings, moved forward where therefore it's your 5-minute submission, electronic submission, which will be both evaluated both at round one and round two. Other than that, every other step will be as plain and as experienced last year. So one fundamental requirement or request from the jurors: keep us excited, tell a clear story, make it linear, help us understand the context when you're presenting it, and also understanding the judging criteria, make the case as compelling as possible. All the very best, and looking forward to judging some exciting stuff from all of you.
So the biggest changes that we had this year for the blueprint was from 2018 to Slim 2.0 was to really look at homing in on some of the core skills that we really want to enhance. And if you look at how we set up the first year was to really look at some of the fundamentals in terms of uplifting the digital marketing industry in Sri Lanka. So we broke it down into different industries as well as had four special award categories. But what we did this year is because considering how fast digital marketing is changing globally, and for us to keep pace with that, what we decided to do was we brought in a new category called international, which is actually recognizing brands of Sri Lankan origin who want to go international and who are marketing themselves digitally internationally. So because we believe that obviously for Sri Lanka to really progress, we need to get more of our brands going overseas, making some dollars coming in. The country really needs it, right? And it's very hard for our brands to compete in the international marketplace with mainstream media. We can't afford it with our kind of budgets. So digital is one way in which we can do that. So that's one change we made in the blueprint to bring in that international category. Another thing we did was bring in those 7 special awards categories, right? The special awards categories are looking at specific skill sets in digital marketing, which we didn't have in the first year. First year, people competed in the mainstream categories, and the judging panel looked at would qualify for the special award category, which were 4 last year. This year, people have to apply. So they had to look at, let's say, best SEO, SEM, best use of technology in marketing, etc., etc. So there are 7 categories there. The next thing is we were really looking at redefining how people approach this process. Last year, we said, look, you have to come and present after having submitted a video. This year, we are going all digital, right? Nobody has to come and present. The video is, we've set a time limit of 5 minutes. In that 5 minutes or below, you can create a compelling case. So that's one way in which you can do it. And the judging process too, the changes we've done is basically the judges, there's a first pre-screening stage where technical judges will go through some of those entries and they will look at how realistic some of those things, because we know in award shows how people are trying to manipulate some of those numbers and things like that. So we have a pre-screening team who will look at basically how what are the clarifications that the judging panel will really need. So they have a 7 days period, grace period, to come back with some of those clarifications. Then the second round judging is based on looking, they can make the individual scores, but there's an opportunity to discuss. So that's another change we made this year. Rather than individually just scoring, we can discuss amongst all the judges, come to a certain amount of consensus. And that way it's much more, let's say the judging process becomes much more efficient because you get a wider perspective of everyone into your judging. So those are some of the changes that we've done to the blueprint this year.
I think this is a unique milestone. And through these 50 years, we were contributing through education, economic development initiatives, and through national level events. We have 5 national level events like People's Awards for last 14 years we were conducting, EFI, the global award show, for last 11 years, Slim NASCO for last 17 years to create sales leaders in this country, and the only platform to recognize brands, brand excellence, Slim brand excellence for past 18 years. Slim Digis is the newest member for our national level awards. So it was started in 2019. So this is Digis 2.0, the second version of it. So we have restarted it. This is the first post-COVID award show that we will have it under Slim banner. So we have restarted the national level events. If you take about Restart Sri Lanka, is a national initiative with the Prime Minister's office. So under Restart Sri Lanka, the first phase is actually the campaign, the positive campaign that build a positive wave among the economy and the country. The second pillar is to actually to re-engineer the businesses and to reinvigorate the economy of this country. There are 5 pillars, 5 initiatives, 5 pillars. The first one is corporate, which we will launch the national sales and business guideline recently, and we will launch the restart scorecard and also public sector trainings. The second pillar is focusing on micro SMEs and inventors. So in this pillar also, digital marketing and digital aspect will be playing a major role. The third pillar is youth. Youth is important pillar in developing the country. So when it under restart Sri Lanka, youth and digital will play a major role in youth pillar also. The fourth pillar will be the nation branding pillar, which also we have the brand week in December, and digital marketing, digital aspect will be a main topic in that symposium. And the fifth pillar will be the knowledge economy. Under knowledge economy, we will launch the SAJM, South Asian Journal of Marketing Journal, and the South Asian Journal of Marketing Management symposium. So the digital will be a talking topic on this journal and also in the symposium. So these are the 5 pillars. And so I think coming digital marketing, the importance of digital marketing will be across all the pillars. So as a Sri Lanka Institute of Marketing, we will taking the country to the next level.
When we talk about the concept, actually after the pandemic situation, I had a challenge of how to conduct this kind of an event with the pandemic situation. Then actually I had a chat with all my team here at Slim, and apart from that, Imal and Tilan. So we get all the advice from them. And we decided to have it online. Basically, there was a lot of challenges, how we are going to have it online. So maybe different platforms, but some of our members wanted to come to expose themselves to this kind of a pandemic situation. Then we actually had a couple of mock-up sessions to prior this press conference, and we acquired some knowledge, new knowledges as well, how to conduct this kind of press conference, because we just wanted to mute some people from the other side, and that kind of a different scenario. We just wanted to plan and have a separate trial basis events. Apart from that, if I'm talking about the final event, so we actually anticipated this pandemic situation goes up, how we are going to conduct our final event also, moving forward to a digital platform. So nice idea came up, even the providing foods to home, they can have their own food, having whatever the food that we have provided, and online session, to have this kind of online session over the final event as well. I know, but it's a challenging thing, but as a Slim team, so we always face our challenges, we overcome our challenges with the new innovation. And I think on behalf of VP Tilanka, I can talk about a little bit of how we are going to move forward with all our events in the future as well. So hopefully our team is confident when it comes to an event. So all the judging process and everything, we have prepared our own system in-house at Slim. So any judger can, you can avoid some of the entry for some of judges who is having a conflict of interest from one industry to another industry. And likewise, we have developed a comprehensive judging system, even though EFIS Global has approved that. And one more thing I just wanted to add, that when it comes to DIGIS, again, back to DIGIS, so Digital Marketing Institute in Ireland, so DMI, so they also came on board this time with us to endorsing DIGIS here in Sri Lanka.
IslandPulse.lk. Now with 2 streams of unlimited music to suit your mood.